Hi, I'm Jasmine.
And I am Harrison.
We are from El Paso, Texas.
Welcome to Children's Time.
Next up, we have an interview with Brother IDK.
Enjoy, kids!
Hi, kids. I have Brother IDK here with us on video call. Hi, Brother IDK. Hi. Hi. Well, today, we continue with the story of Elijah. This week, we look at the story of Elijah with the widow, where she gives him her last meal. What's wrong? I don't know why she would give Elijah her last meal. If she gives it him, then she won't have anything. Have you read the story before? No. But I don't need to read the story to know nothing from nothing leaves nothing. That story can't end well. Well, we'll see. Next up, kids, some nature pictures and videos, and then our Sabbath school lesson about Elijah. You see, 1 minus 1 equals 0. And keepers have, and givers have nothing. That's just science. But you don't know nothing about that because you are not a scientist. I'm a scientist. Like Ray and Rhea said last week, they know.
Be careful.
Hi, kids. Today we continue our story about Elijah. Now you will remember that he told King Ahab it wasn't going to rain for a long time. And then God told him to run off. And so let's see if you run. Yeah, that's good. And so he was able to get water and get food from the birds by the brook Cherith or Kereth, where after a while the brook dried up. And so God sent him somewhere else. So we're going to pick up the story here in 1 Kings chapter 17, beginning at verse 7. And it came to pass after a while that the brook dried up because there had been no rain in the land. And the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, Arise, get thee to Zarephath, which belongeth to Zidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded a widow woman there to sustain thee. So he arose and went to Zarephath. Well, let's pause right there. Even though Elijah was following God, he ran out of food and water. That's one thing we can learn. Bad things can happen to good people. Another thing we can learn is that God will provide for our needs. In fact, our memory verse says, He is our God, and we are under His care. Psalm 95, verse 7. That's from the New International Version. The other thing I want to point out is that probably Elijah would not have expected to see a person in Zarephath who believed in God. But this lady did believe in God. Okay, back to our scripture. 1 Kings 17, now we're at verse 10. So he arose and went to Zarephath. And when he had came to the gate of the city, behold, the widow woman was there gathering up sticks. And he called to her and said, Fetch me, I pray thee, a little water in a vessel that I may drink. And as she was going to fetch it, he called to her and said, Bring me, I pray thee, a morsel of bread in thine hand. And she said, As the Lord thy God liveth, I have not a cake, but a handful of meal in a barrel, and a little oil in a cruse or a container. And behold, I am gathering 2 sticks, that I may go in and dress it for me and my son, that we may eat it and die. Here we see that this woman didn't have much herself, And she didn't think her and her son would sustain, or I should say survive, this famine. Okay, back to the scripture. 1 Kings 17 and verse 12 said, "And Elijah said unto her, Fear not, go and do as thou hast said, but make me thereof a little cake first, and bring it unto me, and after make for thee and for thy son. For thus saith the Lord God of Israel, The barrel of meal shall not waste, neither shall the cruse of oil fail, until the day that the Lord sendeth rain upon the earth." Wow. What do you think the lady thought when Elijah told her to make a cake for him first? I think I would have thought he was being rude. Do you think the lady did what Elijah asked? Do you think God took care of her and Elijah? Yes, she did do what Elijah said, because she knew it was a message from God. And God did just what God promised. Why? Because he is our God, and we are under his care. Hi, kids. Let's see how this would look, or what it would seem like, if the lady was making all kinds of different things all that week for her son and for herself and for Elijah. So here's her barrel, or her container of flour. So she probably put some in for cake. She probably had some for pancakes. And just kind of look, can you kind of see? It's up to here, but it's going to go down, right? I mean, right? Okay, well, let's see. She made some bread. She made some rolls the next day, and waffles the next day, and on the sixth day, probably some cinnamon rolls and some biscuits, so she'd have biscuits on Sabbath. And then probably she made all kind of other things. And then finally, it just kept on coming. And then she looked at, can you guys see it? There's still flour in there. That could only happen because of God. Because God is our God, and he cares for us. Isn't that amazing to think about? Well, in good times and bad times, let's always remember this story, that God is our God, and we are under his care. Do you know other stories about Elijah? Well, since we're talking about Elijah and talking about gifts and talents today, I thought it would be awesome to have a child share a talent and share about Elijah at the same time. Up next, a 9-year-old, Malachi. He will be sharing his gift of preaching and will share about Elijah and prayer.
Happy Sabbath, church. How many of you are happy to be in the house of the Lord today? I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Before I begin, let's give glory to God in prayer, shall we? Dear Lord, I thank you for this day. I thank you for giving us this day to worship you. I pray that you will help us to do good in your sight. And I pray that you will help me to preach the word to give to your people. And I pray that they will leave remembering that prayer is power, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Psalm 100 says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, O ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. So today I want to talk about prayer and how prayer moves mountains. How prayer has brought down false gods. How prayer has brought down fire from heaven. Do I have a witness in this place this morning? More prayer, more power. More prayer,
more power.
More prayer,
more power.
Amen.
Amen.
So can we talk about Elijah? He was a praying man. He loved God. And one day he was praying that it wouldn't rain because everybody wasn't worshiping the true God. He was just worshiping a statue. For example, you take a rock, carve it into a model and call it God, but it's still just a rock carved by human hands. They have eyes, but they cannot see. They have ears, but they cannot hear. They have feet, but they cannot walk. Okay, back to the story. He was praying that it wouldn't rain except at his word, because everybody was worshiping Baal. After 3.5 years, Elijah came again with a challenge for King Ahab to burn bulls to give the evening sacrifice. Whichever God brought down fire would be the true God. Baal and his prophets went first, and nothing happened. And Elijah said, "Why is your God not answering you? Baal must be a god. Maybe he's asleep, using the restroom, or traveling somewhere." To find out what Elijah did, please turn with me to 1 Kings 18:36 through 39. And when you have it, please say amen. And it says, "At the usual time for offering the evening sacrifice, Elijah walked up to the altar and proved that I have done all this at your command. O Lord, answer me. Answer me so these people will know that you, O Lord, are God, and that you have brought them back to yourself." Immediately, the fire of God flashed down from heaven and burned up the wood, the stones, the dust. It even licked up all the water in the trench. And when the people saw it, they fell face down on the ground and cried, "The Lord, he is God. Yes, the Lord is God." You see, people of God, Elijah believed in prayer, but he also believed in the God who he was praying to. When we pray, we must believe that the God who made the heavens and the earth hears you and can deliver you. So the next time trouble comes your way, you remember the God who governs angels' armies is with us. More prayer? More prayer? More prayer? Amen?
Amen.
And please remember, when God says your sins are forgiven, you are clean. That's power. So what we can learn from that is, when we pray for forgiveness, God will give it to us. That's power. So who believes that God will forgive you? That's power. How many of you believe that God will bless you? That's power. How many of you believe that God will use you? That's power. How many of you believe that God can send you? That's power. He is sending you to do his bidding. So how many of you want to be sent by God? That's power. And for me, prayer is power, because when I pray for my mother, when she was mentally attacked, she was healed by sunrise. No one can tell me that prayer is not power. That's power. No one can tell me who I'm with. That's power. No one can tell me if my God is real. That's power. So remember, prayer is power. In the words of Isaiah, "Send me, Lord, send me." God bless you all.
That was a wonderful message, inspiring us to trust that God is powerful to answer our prayers. And what an awesome gift of preaching. Thank you, Malachi. Kids, do you have a gift of preaching or speaking? Do you have another gift or talent? I hope you will share it with us here in Oaktown. Your parents can email me at oaktownlive@gmail.com to let me know what you would like to do. Also, you can send me a picture of you doing your gift or talent, and I will show it during our Performing Arts Center theme song. Well, let's get back to our interview with Brother IDK. What's wrong? I don't know. But we're at a place where I think we should have a song, but I can't think of one. No, I don't know. Yeah, I get it. You're right. Hey, how about I do the song "Joy in the Lord"? I don't know. I don't know if you can do that. I think that you should have Leopold Cram do that one. Yeah, that's what I think. Because you're not a scientist, and that's a guitar song, so you can't do that. You don't play guitar. I think you should have Leopold Cram do it. Okay. Sounds like a good idea to me. What's wrong? I don't know. I don't know how you listen to me. I don't know. I mean, you never listen to me. I don't know. But it makes sense because I don't know some things. Well, kids, Up next, Leopard Cram. But I do know most things. Yeah. Yeah, most things. I know them, most things. I'm glad you see that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Hey, kids. I'm Leopard Cram. Yeah. Pastor Phil don't know how to play guitar like me. This song is called Joy in the Lord. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. Let me hear you. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. Here's the verse. Elijah wanted some food. The widow thought he was rude. But God said, give your last meal. She did, her pantry was filled. Here's the chorus. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. Peter needed some money. It seemed Christ said something funny. Go get your cash from a fish. And Peter caught a goldfish. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. The drink ran out at a wedding. Some thought Jesus was just kidding. Said put water in a jar. It was the best drink by far. Joy in the Lord. I hear you. Joy in His Word. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. Someday you'll have a need and find it hard to believe. But do what God says and you'll get blessed. Let me hear you sing it out. Joy in the Lord. Let me hear the guitar. Joy in His Word. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. Play your instrument. Bam, 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 bam. Let me hear you. Yeah. Bam, 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 bam. Ah, back to the chorus. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. Joy in the Lord. Joy in His Word. Do you have joy in the Lord? Do you enjoy God's Word? I do too. And so does Leopard Cram. Some people say we look alike. Do you think so? Of course, you know I'm just kidding. I like acting. And acting is a talent or gift from God. I'm not perfect at it. Are you perfect at something? Well, actually, I'm not perfect at anything. And really, truth be told, neither are any of us. Only God does things perfectly. But that shouldn't stop us from using our gifts and talents for God. So I hope we will all use our gifts and talents for God, even though we're not perfect in using them. Well, here's a song that talks about no one's perfect, and that's why we need Jesus. It's sung by the Walls Group, and it will be performed by Under His Strings.
This song is not for you. If you never cried a river or had your heart broken too, this song is not for you. If every day you wake up, the skies are blue.
If you love judging others, but you make the same mistake.
Thank you, Understrings. Well, in just a minute, we'll see pictures of children sharing their talents, and you will hear my son Mark singing the Performing Arts Center theme song. But for now, let's have our giveaway. And I picked Kendra M. Congratulations, you will get your prize this week.
God is wonderful, God is marvelous. God gave us Jesus to live and die for us. Now we've got the power to live victorious. Always represent the Savior. God is wonderful, God is marvelous. God gave us Jesus to live and die for us. Now we've got the power. Always represent the Savior. When you sing, when you play, when you act, maybe.
the angels praise. When you're at home or you're away, always represent the Savior. When you write, when you speak, when you draw, may God be pleased. When you're a church or community, always represent the Savior. And God is wonderful, God is marvelous, and God gave us Jesus to live and die for us. Now we've got the power to live victorious. Always represent the Savior. And God is wonderful, God is marvelous, and God gave us Jesus to live and die for us. Now we've got the power to live victorious. Always represent the Savior.
Let's pray. Dear Father, please help us to know that you are God and that you care for us through meeting our needs and through giving us gifts and talents. In Jesus' name, amen.